This video may not be for the faint of heart, so if you tend to get queasy, you might want to click out of this right now and watch one of our other less disturbing videos. If you think you can handle it though, then by all means continue watching. But don't say we didn't warn you. The idea is like something out of a horror film. You're groggy, in a haze, and your surroundings are blurry, yet you're conscious. At first you assume that you're waking up because your surgery is over, but then you hear the murmuring of busy doctors and the rhythmic beeping of a heart monitor. It's then when you figure out, to your ultimate dismay, that the surgery isn't over yet. You've woken up too early. You begin to panic. Your heart rate increases. You suddenly realize that you're in pain. A lot of pain. Agonizing, unbearable pain. As your vision begins to clear, you witness with terror that your internal organs are exposed. The surgeons have sliced you wide open and are using tools while working inside of you. You scream. They realize that you're awake, and the doctors look to you with a sudden alarm. A mad frenzy then ensues as medical staff rush to put you back to sleep. That's the nightmare scenario. But is this based on any truth in reality? What happens if you wake up during surgery? For those who have ever been told that they have to undergo surgery, whether it be for something simple or complex, a familiar question tends to surface. Will I feel anything? The doctor reassures you, explaining that you'll be placed under anesthesia and enjoy a blissful sleep without experiencing any pain throughout the process. For a while, you may be feeling calm. Then your imagination runs wild, then you wonder anxiously, what happens if I'm not fully asleep or I wake up in the middle of the procedure? For those of us without medical expertise, this is a legitimate question and we want to know what we're getting into before we go under the knife. Remember in the TV show Lost, when the doctor had to help perform his own appendectomy? That was one painful scene we hope no one has to go through in real life. It's easy to imagine that being awake during surgery would be a very unpleasant experience. After all, getting a paper cut is painful enough, let alone watching yourself being cut open by a scalpel. Rest assured, if you're under enough anesthesia, you won't be conscious through any of it. It's said that in about 1 or 2 of every 1,000 surgical procedures using general anesthesia, a patient may become aware or conscious of what's going on. This number, however, is disputed with another study of over 200,000 participants showing a 0.0068% of patients experiencing consciousness during surgery. This is a phenomenon known as anesthesia awareness. During this very rare occurrence, patients are said to be able to recall their surroundings or an event related to the surgery while they're under anesthesia. So, for example, if the surgeons were rocking out the song Bryan Adams while performing your surgery, you could recall that you heard the song Cuts Like a Knife during your ordeal. This might end up being somewhat embarrassing for the surgeons who were caught not putting on a professional front, thinking they could get away with a jam session while you were under. Before you jump to conclusions wondering if you've experienced anesthesia awareness during your last surgery, it's important to note that many people dream during surgery, which might cause them to believe they were aware of it when they were not. We spoke with some doctors who suggested the strong possibility that anesthesia awareness is a myth. This is simply for the reason that if you're heavily under with enough anesthesia to put you out through a complicated surgery, you can't wake up at all. Unless you have superpowers and you're impervious to the medication, you cannot gain consciousness, let alone experience awareness of your surroundings. The experts explained that this is simply impossible. This is not to say, however, that a patient who claims to have been through the ordeal is lying, but rather more likely to be experiencing false memories. False memories are those in which we perceive to be true but are not grounded in reality. Because memories are complex and often unreliable, there's a lot of evidence to suggest that they can be reconstructed, molded like Play-Doh, and undergo change, either as people age or as their views or interpretations over a situation change. Thus, our minds leave us with a lot of flexibility and leeway for the production of false memories. We may even sometimes interpret our dreams as actual events that happened to us. But what about those rare instances when patients can recount exactly what happened during their surgery with surprising accuracy? Can that happen by chance? It's a topic that's widely open for debate. Whether based on false memories or not, when patients perceive anesthetic awareness, it can often be highly upsetting and sometimes frightening, leading some to experience post-traumatic stress. This may be due in large part to the sensation of not being able to move or signal for help while going through it, which can be very intense. Some of these patients benefit from counseling after surgery to help them cope with their confusion and the stress from the procedure. These are, however, pretty extreme cases and not very common. During anesthesia awareness, it's not generally said that patients feel physical pain. So this would eliminate the horrific idea of a patient waking up mid-surgery screaming, as if under extreme medieval torture. At most, people might recall a feeling of pressure, but that's about the extent of it. If you envision something more drastic or dramatic than this, like the scenario discussed at the beginning of this episode, we're sorry to disappoint you. Hopefully though, if you have a surgery scheduled soon, you're feeling comforted right now by the knowledge that you likely won't feel pain during your operation. Recovery, however, is another subject for another day. We wish you luck with that aspect of it. Physician anesthesiologists are said to be among the most highly skilled medical experts when it comes to pain management and anesthesia care. In order to become one, you have to go through the same grueling process of any other doctor. First, you have to go through medical school, then complete a 4-year anesthesiology residency, training with highly skilled medical school faculty. Following the residency, some doctors proceed to do a fellowship in order to further train in anesthesiology specialties. So the good news is that if you're going to be a patient in a clinical or hospital setting undergoing an upcoming routine surgery, you'll likely be in good hands with very little to worry about. The concept of anesthesia awareness is said to be more common for surgeries when the typical dose of anesthesia required to put someone fully to sleep is deemed unsafe for the specific condition. Surgeries using less anesthetic might include certain types of heart surgery, surgeries for traumatic injuries, and emergency C-sections. The last one is typical since it's too dangerous for a pregnant mother to be completely under due to the risk of harming her unborn child. Nevertheless, common sense would dictate that it's more likely patients will recall what happened during surgery when they're not fully put to sleep to begin with. With that under consideration, higher chances and prevalent rates of anesthesia awareness are associated with procedures that do not involve general anesthesia. These include the use of other lighter forms of anesthesia or sedation. For minor procedures such as a colonoscopy, a certain type of biopsy, or even a dental procedure, the use of intravenous or twilight sedation is more common. No, we're not talking about those sparkling vampires that were all the rage back in the 2000s. What we mean is an anesthetic technique where only a mild dose of general anesthesia is used, mainly to reduce anxiety. During this type of sedation, the patient can be described as not unconscious but sedated, so you may be aware of your surroundings without being fully present, if that makes sense. It's basically like being relaxed and sleepy, drifting in and out but still responsive and able to follow directions from your doctor. Thus, this technique gets its name because patients are in what's known as a twilight state of mentality, somewhere between consciousness and unconsciousness. Let's see if you can wrap your head around what that might be like. Local or regional anesthesia is another form of sedation, which often includes the use of epidurals, spinal blocks, or nerve blocks. This should not put you to sleep, so you'll still be aware of what's going on. This method only temporarily numbs an area that is undergoing treatment during surgery. You might recognize the epidural as being commonly used for pregnant mothers going through intense labor pain. In this case, the epidural is administered by injecting a small amount of anesthetic directly into the spine. Ouch! Pain relief usually occurs about 10 to 20 minutes later because the medicine is introduced gradually. If working properly, the woman should no longer feel pain and be numb in the lower part of her body. Only about 1 out of 100 women need additional painkillers when they have an epidural. Considering the extent of labor pain, this can seem unbelievable. Try telling a woman in labor that she doesn't need more painkillers, and let's see if you get out of there alive. Often, however, a single injection isn't enough to last throughout the entire birthing process. Many might agree that childbirth must be among the worst on the list of medical situations to have to be wide awake for. Imagine, for a moment, being fully conscious while you're basically being torn apart as a potential watermelon or a bowling ball-sized human makes its way emerging outward through the cramped vaginal canal. Perhaps it's comparable to a real-life version of that iconic scene in the famous 1979 film Alien. Remember when the xenomorph busted from Kane's stomach? Okay, we're over-exaggerating just a bit. Childbirth isn't always quite as dramatic as this, but you get the idea. It's still a messy bloodbath that the woman is required to stay awake for, though there are many who view it as miraculous. Whether you believe this to be the case is a highly subjective matter, so we'll turn it back to you. If you've experienced the pleasure or disgust of witnessing an actual childbirth, would you say it was more or less disturbing than a scene from a horror movie? We'd be curious to learn your opinion. As a side note, the next time you visit the dentist and complain about the pain of your root canal while requesting extra laughing gas, you may be interested to know that you're getting more, if not the same amount of relief, that many women who have given birth before. This is because laughing gas was at one time widely used as a popular method of relieving labor pain in Germany. Let that sink in your mind for just a moment. Aren't you glad we told you? So, which medical procedure do you believe would be the worst to have to be awake for? Have you ever woken up during surgery? We'd like to hear your story. Let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video, Why Are People Dying from Brazilian Butt Lift Surgery? Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.